crap that you're
streaming.
If I can squeeze in 3 points, I'm
just trying to. Have you already posted
the film? Should have done all that.
Huh? Back on again.
Just for that.
I want to flag up actually a bit about BARAC very quickly. The BARAC is a national campaign group fighting the cuts and fighting the disproportionate impact of cuts on deprived communities and black communities served users and workers. And yesterday we held in Stratford our alternative to the opening of the Olympics. And we had a public meeting where John McDonnell and many others spoke, which was called Jobs and Justice, Olympics Fair Play for Who. And I want to flag up one of the speakers that was there. It was from the Carpenters Road campaign, which is in Stratford. And for those of you that may have seen any of the BBC reports on the Olympics, the BBC have taken over a section of a tower block. They've chucked the residents out. They want to gentrify the area. They want to get rid of those tower blocks altogether. And the residents in that estate are running a campaign to try to defend their tower blocks and their house on the estate. And I just want people to get behind that campaign and go down there and visit the support, because they're using security of their visitors to keep people out of their own properties, and we need to stand up for them and stand by them. That's a clear example of the disgraceful behaviour of those organising the Olympics. Okay, my first poem,
what's it called again?
Poem I wrote for David Cameron.
E-A-M-U-S-E-R.
Yeah.
But he
is that better than
hear my message.
Well, the live, we were going to look at using live stream, but they're putting a cost on it.
They're putting a what?
And I wrote it in response to Cameron's comments where he demonised young people
while
summer during the riot.
Just the USB chargers.
I mean, like, what is the charging? Where does the power come from?
Yeah, still you were a gang member. Grew up in luxury, but that didn't curb your temper.
Oh.
You never experienced prostitution, yet still ended up in an institution with your gang, acting like a slugging male, destroying properties just for fun, showing no remorse for what you've done.
Wow.
You said you did things when you were young that you believe you shouldn't have done, but still you managed to escape the judicial system, each time throwing money to bribe your victim, drinking, vomiting on, and trashing property, but not as a response to extreme poverty. You said, I wonder, after your parents found out who you were with, were they able to forgive? Hanging around with fellow thugs of your Bullingdon gang? Did they discipline you or forbid you to hang with George and Boris in your gangster paradise, destroying businesses before the owner's eyes? Perhaps as you escaped punishment at the time, you should be evicted from number 10 for your crime. Perhaps you ought to practice what you preach and receive a prison sentence, pledge your remorse and demonstrate your repentance. You stated that children today end up in gangs through neglect. Shame on your parents that your childhood was wrecked. Perhaps if your parents had kept you at home instead of forcing you to live alone, you wouldn't have committed the violent crimes you did than when the police came, ran away and hid. It seems that your bad upbringing led to a lifetime of stealing, thank you, taking taxpayers' money for your conservatory roof resealing and other property repairs which you agreed to repay, yet you continued thieving public sector pensions and pay. Your lack of respect for family values and failure to collect revenue has led to many of your friends committing crime, avoiding and failing to pay their taxes on time. This has led to parents of the children you despise having to work two or three jobs just to survive. You've been taxing the poor to pay the rich more. So, Mr. Cameron, when you talk about breaking the law, perhaps you need to look past your own front door.
Encore! Encore!
Okay, I wrote this next poem only a few days ago. A week ago, I ran a campaign because I found out that the oldest, biggest black newspaper in the UK, The Voice newspaper, hadn't been given media accreditation, so they couldn't report from within the Olympic Stadium when the Olympic bid was won on London's multi-ethnic population. So I ran a campaign, 3,000 people ran, signed a petition, politicians and various people got behind, and in 2 days they made a U-turn and they gave them a pass to report from the Olympics. So I wrote this poem. Now, because there's children around, there's a certain word in the poem that I can't use, so you're going to have to use your imagination when I go blank, yeah? Olympic this, taking the... No, 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 we can't accept this, but to show that we mean business. So I lodged a petition to let them know the position. Blatant disregard for a whole community. BOA acting so disgracefully. Local, or we locals tried to ignore us, but we said, hell no. People from around the world signed their names. As it grew, it brought more Olympic shame. Exploitation of workers. Tax dodging by sponsors. Then the fiasco of G4S and a green custard still arrest. Olympic this, taking the... No, 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 we can't accept this, but to show that we mean business. Oldest, biggest black newspaper in Britain, disregarded rather than forgotten. 14 strong committee, 12 men, all white, acting like the inequality of their decision was all right. Outraged public on change.org kept on signing, finding it shocking, not just surprising, to be in this disgraceful situation when London's multi-ethnic population was used to win the Olympic bid, yet they want ethnic press to be hid. Politicians and activists joined the campaign to win, and even London's Mayor Boris got stuck in. Olympic this, taking the... No, 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 you can't say that here. But to show them we mean business. Nearly 3,000 people on change.org signed their name, whilst international press reported daily on this Olympic shame. BOA refused to say which media was accredited, and quite rightly got challenged and publicly slated. Their message clear, if you're black, get back. If you're white, you're right. Happy for black athletes to represent, but not for black press to be present. BOA gives the BBC 800 passes, whilst The Voice only asking for 2, it dismisses, using blanket criteria that discriminates against specialist press that it eliminates. But unable to ignore, they had to learn. Pressure and shame led to a U-turn. In just 60 hours, collective action made history. And People Power claimed the first Olympic victory. Yes. They're taking that. Yes. No, 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 we can't accept this. So assure them we have business. Thank you.
Very much. Things have been so succinct as well, because sadly, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, things are building up a little bit around the park. The police are starting to regroup, and I think our time is slowly coming to the end. So, unfortunately, despite having lots of fabulous campaigns, come up, the next speaker, which is a poet, we're going to end on a poem. It's going to be our last speaker, I'm afraid, ladies and gentlemen. So, please do come up here, and if you want to get any information about the campaign, join us, go to the website, speak to the Save Leighton Marsh comrades over here, who are absolutely fantastic, and they've been leading a heroic campaign over in Leighton Marsh, and also fantastic runner there. If you want some running advice off Sharon, she'll help you. So please do get involved in the campaign. We're really sorry we haven't had enough time to speak to Deepak. We've got some fantastic things to do. Loads of other organisations, Occupy are here, the London Mining Network, New Monitoring Project, No Go, Cage Prisoners and Space Hijackers. We're really sorry, but the final speaker is going to be Danny Chivers, the poet, ladies and gentlemen. Please give it up for him.
Thank you.
Hello.
I'm not going to ask very much from you. It's going to be all be quite quick, but a nice way you asked him would be good. So, hello. Oh, yeah. Yes, so my name is Danny Chivers, and I'm involved with the UK Tar Sands Network and with the Reclaim Shakespeare Company. I'm also a performance poet, and I'm going to do a poem now, and then we'll have a, something a little bit unusual and special to finish with. It's going to involve some other people. So, but this poem is about all the stuff that they're trying to distract us from. This poem is called...
There,
out of control. Stamp. This one's a sphere, just a sphere, and a quick swig of the kind of thing. Moving silent in time. No sounds of alarm, no remorse, no undue force, no hate. Just a riot of quiet efficiency. As they lay waste to your community. An Armani army of suited looters behind computers. Perverse, reverse Robin Hoods. I am effing up your name.
So, care homes hustled carelessly away under tailored jackets. Housing projects shoved into trouser pockets. Hospitals lost in all the confusion to be later retrieved from a neatly pressed sleeve. It's smash and grab capitalism, linked up by Blackberries, texting the next best place to squeeze so your youth centres and libraries are plundered under the cover of darkness. I'll show up tomorrow on the global market, spray buckets in colour. On the radio today, they talked about banker bashing. Said the financial sector was sick of being hectored, but it didn't deserve such a public thrashing. It was time to move on. I quite agree. The bankers didn't do this alone. They're just a symptom of a system that's out of control, that reduces human aspiration to the humorless accumulation of wealth, to the pursuit of profit as the end in itself. Get with the program or get back on the shelf. Join the fat pack, reeling off the best contracts, privatise and corporatise any public effects you can use to redirect the tools of other spoils back round to yourself.
Say that,
what future you can choose to have? What most startup capital, you loser?
Well, just take out a loan or ten. Ride the backs of the dragon straight out of the den and blast a few flames of your own back down the back streets you used to call home. Unless, of course, you're part of the crowd without the connections, vowel inflections or financial clout, academic laurels or basic lack of morals required to build your own commercial empire. In which case, I hope you like the taste of dragonfly. But there is another way, as the adverts say, we can refuse to play the game as laid out by these authorised crooks, tripping the planet along with the books in a final cash-crashing gush of fossilised fuels. But while they're changing the climate, we're changing the rules, fueled by compassionate rage. It's tempting, I admit, to go, let's strip them of their benefits, force them to live on an average wage, but let's rise higher than the simple desire for revenge. Let's spread our ambitions wide, both indignant and dignified. If we're the 99%, then if we take back our consent, then they become irrelevant. Yes, we're the 99%, so if we take back our consent, then they're irrelevant. So the moral of the story is, although it might seem rather fun to bash each banker one by one, a bigger beast requires your passion. This whole damn system needs a passion. So now we're going to finish off with a fantastic panel performance, which I need to invite two special guests on the stage. Would you please welcome Jess and Emily from the UK Tar Sands Network? And, I should tell you that Jess is one of the Custard Seven who was arrested last Friday for pouring green custard over her head in an anti-green wash protest in Trafalgar Square.
You filthy custard criminal!
So we are also known as, we're part of the Reclaim Shakespeare Company. You see, BP's sponsorship of the Olympics doesn't just include sponsoring the sport, they are also sponsoring, as part of that deal, the World Shakespeare Festival, and a series of plays at the Royal Shakespeare Company. And we thought it was a bit inappropriate and disgusting that BP should be getting its oily fingers all over our culture and our theatre, and so we formed well, I've got a lot of people now involved in the Reclaim Shakespeare Company, and we've been doing a little bit of direct theatrical action. We've been getting up as a little surprise at the beginning of BP-sponsored plays and doing little pop-up guerrilla Shakespeare protest performances on the stage before they can check us out. So, in order to explain this properly, we thought we'd reenact one for you. So, all you're going to see now is a very short piece that we originally performed on the stage at the Roundhouse Theatre a month or so ago. Before a performance of the BP-sponsored Comedy of Errors. What we didn't know was, by interesting coincidence, it was actually coincided with a BP staff corporate schmoozing event. And so there were loads of BP staff in the audience with senior members of the Royal Shakespeare Company as well. We had no idea what was happening. So as we perform this, you have to imagine that you're there in that audience, surrounded by BP staff, watching this surprise piece of guerrilla Shakespeare happen. So I better get my costume on. Most important part of the costume here.
It's a greenwash rough.
By the pricking of my thumb, something wicked this way comes.
Now you have to imagine that the theatre is about to go dark and everyone is expecting the Comedy of Errors to begin. And all of a sudden we walked on stage and we said, ladies and gentlemen, we are the Reclaim Shakespeare Company. We're now going to give a 2-minute performance about BP sponsorship of this place.
Twas here I did encounter two weird brothers. The first of them was wreathed in verdant green, a book of sweet verse clasped against his breast, a merry music whistling through his lips. What ho, stranger!
Sirrah, I am a patron of the arts, forever in the company of players. I'd gladly sponsor theatres, galleries, shows, and spend my leisure planting trees and tending to the earth. There's not a man I meet that doth salute me.
A fine and worthy man, thought I, as he skips on his way. But then a second fellow did approach, a noxious, treacherous, belching, oily rogue, poisoner of forest, land and sea, destroyer of the Gulf of Mexico, responsible for grief unspeakable, his body dark with tar and bleeding oil. Begone, thou swaggering rascal, did I cry.
Dost thou not know me, friend? I am no stranger. Thou spakest with me but a moment hence. Though thou hast sworn me fair and thought me bright, I am as black as hell, as dark as night.
Your face is like a criminal!
I'm the poet in but one single body. Am I mad? But as I watched, the monstrous, tar-drenched knave did black the green garb of the fragrant bard. No gentle patron this, an oily devil, taking fair nature as his green-tinged guise. A goodly apple, rotten at the core. Yet, here sit we, believing this conceit, that BP sponsors Shakespeare and the Olympics as partner in sustainability, a green and pleasant brand for all to see, and not a devil in a poet's mask who with his daring folly burns the world. Enough, no more. Now is the summer of our discontent and dark night.
company. If you share our concerns about BT's sponsorship of the arts and the Olympics, please join us in ripping the logo out of your program. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy the company event.
So yeah, we did actually get some applause, which was a bit of a surprise, considering he was in the audience. But what I want to say is that we're going to be doing more of this stuff, and if you'd like to help out, either by joining us in performances, putting on performances of your own, or just helping us to get theatres to adopt ethical sponsorship policies, then please do come and chat to us afterwards, or come and find us on our website, which is inevitably bpornotbp.org. I've put little hyphens in, bp-or-not-bp. Yeah, you get the idea. Anyway, come and find us. There's videos of all our performances up there. Please do come, get involved, and help us kick BP out of the arts. And thank you for being here and being part of this fantastic demonstration. Cheers. Absolutely. If anyone would, we have Elizabeth modelling one of the marvellous Oh No t-shirts here. If anyone would like to buy campaign t-shirts, please see here. Thank you again to all of the campaigns that we haven't had time to speak. Check out the Counter Olympics Network website to find out who those people are. Also, DPAC have got a week of activity next week, which will be on their website, starting on Tuesday. On Monday night, there's going to be a documentary about Atos on Channel 4, is that right? I think I've been told Channel 4. And then after that, there's going to be a whole week of activity, so please get involved in that and check that out. And please give one last huge cheer for everyone who's been part of this organising committee and campaign. Thank you all very much for coming, and see you next time. The struggle continues.
Hello everyone, really sorry about this. It's small looking at
you. Got any of them in XL?
What?
You got any of them in XL?
Large and
Yeah. Four police vans. And one's gone now. I'm going to grab this stuff and walk around with it. Mm-hmm. I've got a t-shirt. Yeah. I don't really like anything like that. It's going to happen. Which is good.
Yeah, the police have moved on.
That's a good thing, they've all parked up.
All
well, no, there's one over there, but.
Well, yeah, one's
no bacon, man.
No bacon. How many viewers are
we at? Just 8.
Hello, viewers.
What's up, man? Probably where we can start it till late. Nothing's actually happened. Same, man. I guess it's a good thing, isn't it? Like, actually, left after yesterday. Sort of just get over it.
Yeah, they put up with a bad friend.
Yeah.
Yahoo.
Yahoo down here, Yahoo News.
Nothing they can speak and nothing they can do. It's no problem for me.
Consider yourselves like the Yes Men?
We're not quite the same as them, because they tend to do like smooth stunts, whereas we are doing like we're sort of subverting the genre and
yeah.
Sort of a little bit different. But I mean, I guess it's like obviously they're inspiring,
yeah.
You know, in that whole kind of playing.
And you had a sort of older sort of theme to it, sort of more poetic theme to it. Because they're more just sort of political, aren't they, about it?
Yeah, I mean, I think they've been very, very clever at, like, doing the whole pretending to be official people in authority,
yeah.
And, like, and getting away with it and going on TV and, like, pretending that something's happened that hasn't and all that sort
yeah,
of
yeah.
Thing. Oh, they did it with the Bhopal.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, like, that was the best one. They got on the BBC World Service, incredible. Didn't they?
Yeah. Yeah. But there was a similar stunt start that wasn't by them, but...
Yeah.
But it was like just done by a bunch of people somewhere in London
yeah.
Who, I don't know if you saw, when there was like an announcement that BP had been dropped as the sustainability sponsor of the Olympics
yeah.
And it went out as a sort of formal looking press release on this like professional looking website, it all looked like the real Olympics website.
Oh, is that the one where you could generate your own images on there? Is that, did you see that one? It was a BP one, that one.
Oh, it was a BP one. No, yeah. it was like a fake news release and a fake website
like a
saying
piece.
That BP had been dropped.
Okay.
As a sustainability partner for the Olympics, and then quite a few like media outlets were fooled by it, and
yeah.
A fake spokesperson went on LBC Radio and was like, yeah, you know, sustainability partners, you know, they're still the oil and gas partners, but it just wasn't appropriate anymore. Before then, it was turned out it was a spoof, and you know, they were angry. so yeah, those things do happen.
Well,
so we've got, like I say, we've got like videos
of
our stuff on the website.
Yeah, I did tweet your address earlier. So yeah, should hopefully get some support.
Oh, good.
So,
what's your name?
Richard.
Yeah, from Danny. Hello.
Danny, nice to meet you. So what have you got anything else planned for the whole Olympics? Cause
yeah,
or is this or is this it?
Well, we've done 5 of these now. The most recent one was last week, actually, at the British Museum,
yeah.
Where we went to the Shakespeare exhibition, which is sponsored by BP at the British Museum, and did a kind of pop-up protest there with 12 people, based on Macbeth, where we had 3 executive witches, like BP executives, going, "When shall BP meet again?" And then we got chucked out by security, but it was quite good because we were able to go, "Look, the security are removing the BP executives from the building. Come, let's help them." And so that was quite fun. So we're thinking, you know, we might do a bit more of that sort of thing. I think we're definitely going to do some more.
Yeah.
We can't say exactly when. It's the whole point is
yeah.
A surprise. But yeah. But if you know, if people want to get involved, then there's definitely opportunities. And also, we're going to be also focusing a bit more on the positive side of the campaign as well soon. Trying to encourage theatres and get people in the theatre world on board to actually say, actually, we need ethical sponsorship of you know, an ethical funding source for the arts and theatres. We shouldn't just be taking money from anyone who works a cheque.
Yeah.
And actually, you know, we need decent public
transport.
Yeah. 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 So yeah, there's all that side of it too. But certainly on the performance side, yeah, you haven't seen the last of us yet.
Yeah, that'd be good. I'd love to see some more. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, you too. Cheers, man.
Oh, nice sticky hand.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
What's the...
Yeah, someone could tweet that BP or not BP org and at it at me, it would be nice. UK watching. So yeah, the police have totally moved off now. People seem to still be hanging around there, so... Here are the Yahoo News reporters again. Just tweet it at me if you could. No friction, and the last part of the no friction is with a number one. Thank you.
I'm check it.
No, because you will not let them.
Thanks, UK Kebabs.
On that week, we're going to have a week of action against that one.
So it'll be before,
yeah.
And finish it off.
It would be better if I could give you I think it's the one.
The excellent sport of it, and it's wonderful to see great sport in people. However, no money is put into local leisure centres, into local sports centres in this area. On the contrary, those things, money that should be going to those things, is put into giving money to corporate sponsors. And so we've put, and various other things, so we're out of the port in this one being
talking to Yahoo News.
Their goals, and of course, when you see an enormous spectacle like Danny Boyle's opening ceremony, where you see things that are undeniably viscerally impressive, it would be wrong of us to bury our heads in the long jump and ignore the fact that, despite the positive things that, you know, have been banned from it and that people having great days out, the majority of people will get tickets. Most of the tickets have gone to corporate sponsors, again, to give to the people that they want to impress and encourage their business. So, for us, it would be wrong of us, it would be wrong to bury our heads in the sand and say that, yes, let's go on, because there are so many injustices being played out like this Olympics. BP, the sustainability sponsor, the green sponsor of apparently the most environmentally friendly games ever. I mean, this is laughable. The idea that Union Carbide, Dow Chemicals, who ran Union Carbide, who we're seeing this as the official food sponsor of the game. And to just say that I like tennis, or I enjoy the underwater basketball thing, or whatever sport it is you enjoy, to say that is, you can enjoy that without this spectre looming over the games, I think is very difficult. And I think our job is to say, well, we're not going to try and disrupt the games, we're not going to try and help them not to go. Our job as the Counter Olympics Network is to raise crucial issues, because these crucial issues, although they are important to us in London now, and they are key issues for many, many people obviously here today, and these are things that are going to happen in the next place. You know, Rio has got the Olympics at the time, and, you know, as people said today, and came from Rio, spoke today, that they are facing the same sort of problem. Rio is an incredibly unequal city, in the same way as London is an incredibly unequal city, and we can tell you categorically, for a fact, that in London, the gap between the rich and the poor has got wider. Inequality has got worse because of this Olympics, and it hasn't got better because of it, but worse, and that is a real shame. Thank you very much. Alright, good guys, I hope you have a lovely time while you're here. Enjoy the games.
What's that? What's that? The camera's in? Livestream.com.
Yeah.
Second time, nothing, man. What did you say there? Just last, this should work. Yeah, as you can see, it's really starting to fizzle down here now.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching.
What else is going on?
The internet's crap, aren't
we? Yeah, this one.
Yeah. Fucking small ass keyboard, man. I think everyone's getting ready to make the final push to leave. Looks like it. Looks like everyone's getting ready to make the final push to leave, isn't it? Trying to find out. We head down to the Occupy camp at Shoreditch Park. Group of official protesters. Well, if two people's a group, then that's a fucking...
Yeah, shit. Gotta be careful.
It's a rabble.
It's a rabble. And they can be arrested. It's coming up to an hour now. Heya. Anything else going on today?
We're involved in the official stuff.
The official stuff?
Yeah.
The official protest.
Okay. Is
there anything going on in the next few days though, or up ahead during the Olympic Games? No? You don't know?
Probably, but
so I know this.
We only know official protests will be going out for official.
Yeah.
We've got an embargo right now. And
yeah, on what you can do, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Can't really, yeah, low cost as well. So, can't really talk about it right now.
Fair enough. Official protesters can't talk. Yeah, I've got more.
No problem.
And the level of expenditure is again one of those things which I have seen kind of required. Again, cities get into this. This is part of the kind of competition between cities. They're trying to become. London is describing itself now as the capital of the world. You know, that is the kind of publicity that's going out in the media. I mean, it's complete nonsense, but this is the kind of ridiculous competition that's going on for corporates, to attract corporations to your city. And so that and the property interest are two big sort of actual, real motivations behind this project. What they talk about in terms of the benefits to improve tourism, it doesn't happen. Actually, get us climate change. They say, one of the extraordinary things they say is, this will make London a world city. I mean, what kind of rubbish is that? As if London was not a world city. I mean, how many cities in the world are better known than London? New York, possibly. I mean,
it's oxymoronic.
Yes, it's moronic, exactly. But no, you see, this stuff is then fed into the press, and the press repeats it ad nauseam. And you get these slogans like, for example, they say they're creating the largest new park in Europe for 150 years. Complete rubbish. I asked the OGA, okay, so you've got a list of parks you could bet it with. Oh, we don't have a list. We don't have to have a list. So how do they know? Actually, they know.
And are you allowed, are you allowed to demonstrate in the Olympic precinct?
They're very cagey about that. Inside of the Olympic, right, you might say where the sort of Stratford station, that line. We're not interested in going down there and having this argument. This is not a disrupt the Olympics type protest. This is to express the opinion. And to be quite blunt, actually, this is mainly foreign media. They're far more interested in the British media. And actually, that in some senses is our interest in a way, because London's already done this. We can't change that. But actually, other countries, I know that Australia's had its go, but a lot of countries don't realise actually what a problem this thing is, and how actually it doesn't deliver benefits to ordinary people. You go to Rio, hundreds of thousands of people are reckoned to be affected by eviction for the two mega events there.
And have the Brazilians been interested in what you're talking about?
Well, we have a Brazilian campaigner here. She's over there talking to the guy in the kind of stripy.
And there's a Brazilian.
Brazilian journalist. But you see, a lot of these places, the enthusiasm is much greater. The interesting thing about Britain is that the British have this reputation for being really kind of rather difficult to please. And so they're always being accused of being moaners and groaners, and so on. But actually, the British public is very right to be sceptical. And only 20% of the people in Britain believe the Olympics are going to deliver any benefits. This is a YouGov poll. And just about half the population now doesn't believe that Britain should ever have applied for the Games. So that's pretty astonishing, considering all the publicity, the propaganda that's been put out, that the British public is absolutely so sceptical about this project. Right. Of course, at the moment, there's a great surge of publicity, and I dare say, the approval ratings will go up.
Yeah.
Then they'll go down again once the Games are over. The honeymoon will be over, and we'll be into the headache, which I believe Sydney had a bit of as well.
Yeah.
Every country it's been running, they've had years of debt. Yeah. What was it? Montreal only paid off last year?
Exactly. But the trouble is, it takes each city gets, the political class gets behind the project, the entire political class of Britain is behind the project, and so you get this terrific kind of surge, and they push it as hard as they can. The money is put into it.
What's your surname, Julian?
Shane. C-H-E-Y-N-E.
And what do you do? What's your...
Well, I'm actually retired.
Okay.
Yeah, because...
What was your trade? What did you...
Well, no, well, I've actually had very severe health problems. I had a condition. I had a viral problem, and which made me virtually housebound for quite a long time. Mm-hmm. I'm recovering from that now. So I actually haven't been working for some time.
Okay.
So you can just say, retired, I guess, because I am actually retired.
And you did live in East London?
Yeah, I lived within the Olympic Park. I lived in a place called Clades Lane, which is the only populated estate in East London. There was another estate, which was a student estate, which was knocked down.
What's there now?
Well, now it's just next door to the Athens Village. It's back of house facilities for the Athens Village.
That's just
north of the Athens Village.
Yeah.
You can't get down there anymore. It's up a road called Temple Mills Lane.
All right. Well, let's do a quick
show
in here.
Yeah, thanks for it. Okay.
Lord Sebastian chairman of the station.
So you have to ask exactly what is the farm. It's not about economic benefits at all. It's actually about property interest. But this is, the IFC requires a creation of a large farm, which means you can possibly purchase a large piece of land, usually in a poor part of the city, which means you then remove those people, and you can create a poor people free zone, and you get rid of the dirty industry of those people. It's very explicitly stated in the policy.
Sign off in a minute. I'm saying, in a way, it's good that there's nothing worth live streaming on. To a certain degree. Not for sick folks like me. Actually, that's what I agree.
Alright, ladies and gents, we're going to sign off. Thank you for watching. And hopefully, we'll be back soon. Also, check
where are we heading out?
Check out the other account. Yeah, we might actually head down to down to the Occupy camp at Shoreditch Park now. So, if so, and there's anything interesting going on down there, we'll stream from down there. Thanks for watching.